Welcome to a quick podcast on cartilage histology and formation. Cartilage is a connective tissue consisting of a dense matrix of elastic fibers and collagen fibers embedded in a rubbery ground substance. The matrix is produced by fibroblast-like cells called chondroblasts. The ground substance is made of hyaluronic acid, a non-sulfated glycosaminoglycan that forms the backbone which the chondroitin sulfate is bound to via a core protein. Of note, the chondroitin sulfate is a sulfated glycosaminoglycan that gives the PAS stain. Chondroblasts are precursor cells being made in the periphery of this tissue called perichondrium. They give rise to chondrocytes, which are surrounded by what is called a lacuna, as they become more and more embedded in the extracellular membrane they created. Essentially, mature cartilage cells are called chondrocytes. As seen in this electron microscopy picture, they form isogenous groups. Isogenous in Latin means equal origin. In other words, these clusters of 2 to 3 cells are the antecedent of a single chondroblast. They are isogenous. Not only does the extracellular matrix that these chondroblasts produce contain the glycosaminoglycans, hyaluronic acid and chondroitin sulfate, or the collagen fibers, it also contains a lot of water because of the negatively charged glycosaminoglycans, which attract water. Here I am drawing a schematic representation of the functional implication of a water-filled matrix. This high water content of the extracellular matrix helps act as a shock absorber, pushing water out at times. As forces exerted on the extracellular matrix, the collagen fibers contract and the water is pushed from the ground substance, allowing for the force to be redistributed throughout the water movement. One important note is that cartilage, for the most part, is avascular, and this means that nutrients only get to these tissues by diffusion. There are 3 different types of cartilage: elastic, hyaline, and fibrocartilage. We will compare the different types and try to construct an understanding of why they are organized so differently. Firstly, hyaline and elastic cartilages contain collagen type 2, while fibrocartilage contains mostly type 1 collagen fibers and alternates between hyaline cartilage and thick collagen fibers in direction of opposing forces. Elastic cartilage has mostly elastic fibers, with some type 2 collagen. Hyaline cartilage, on the spectrum of quantity, has less collagen than does fibrocartilage. Elastic cartilage and hyaline cartilage are surrounded by a perichondrium because of where they are found. Fibrocartilage has no perichondrium. Another clue as to where each type of cartilage is found has been mentioned in the arrangement of fibrocartilage collagen towards the direction of stress. This high-stress environment is found in tendon of muscles which attach to bone. Instead of perichondrium surrounding muscle, there is a fibrous sheath called the epimysium, and that surrounds the fibrocartilage, not a perichondrium. Elastic cartilage is found in the external ear, external auditory meatus, internal auditory meatus, and epiglottis. Hyaline cartilage is found in the long bones, trachea, nose, joints, and bronchi. Finally, fibrocartilage is present in tendon insertions into bone, intervertebral discs, and menisci. The chondrocytes of each tissue look different as well. In elastic tissue, the cells are larger and more densely arranged than hyaline cartilage. Fibrocartilage cells are arranged in parallel rows like boxcars and is often difficult to tell apart from skeletal muscle. The main differentiating factor is that it is much more acidophilic and slightly less structured. 2 last notes about fibrocartilage and hyaline cartilage. Fibrocartilage is present in tendon, as we already discussed. Tendon attachment to bones are often referred to as enthesis, from Greek meaning set within. Therefore, fibrocartilage is often referred to as fibrocartilaginous enthesis. The second note is about hyaline cartilage. There are 2 distinctions made in histological examination of hyaline cartilage. These distinctions are territorial matrix and interterritorial matrix. The former referring to isogenous groups and their enveloping lacunae, and the latter being the rubbery collagen-containing matrix. Now that we understand the different types of cartilage, let's review its mechanism of growth, which is also applicable to bone. The first is apositional growth, which is when new cartilage is formed from chondroblasts of the perichondrium, which is the primary method of growth in mature cartilage. The second term is interstitial growth, which is an increase in the internal mass of cartilage by activity of chondrocytes that multiply within lacunae.